Welcome back. And if you remember last week, we tried latkes and we love them so much. There was the applesauce and the sour cream and we had them plain. Oh my gosh, we stuffed our faces. So we decided we wanted to learn a little bit more about this traditional Jewish food.
Yes, so we invited Figi Saitlin on to give us a demonstration on how to make the perfect latke for Hanukkah. Welcome. It already smells so good in here.
That's good. Good sign. Burning oil though.
Yes, no, it smells already really great. And let's kind of start with the beginning. Tonight will be the start, correct?
Tonight is the first night of Hanukkah, and Hanukkah lasts for 8 days, 8 nights, 8 days, 8 candles. And every day we add another candle to kind of add light to this world. It's a really fun holiday, gifts, Hanukkah gelt, coins or actual gelt money, dreidels, latkes, tons of fried food. What else is there?
Well, why is it that the oil kind of plays a part?
Okay, so the oil is actually the entire miracle of Hanukkah. That's why the holiday is actually celebrated. About 2,000 years ago, when the Greeks came and conquered Jerusalem, they basically took the temple and they totally destroyed it and defiled it. And every day the menorah was lit in the temple, and the Jewish people couldn't find a kosher vial of olive oil to light the menorah. So now they finally found one little vial, but it was only enough to last for one night. So they went and they lit it, but they were kind of distraught that they wouldn't be able to continue. Olive oil takes time to make. And the miracle was that it lasted for 8 days until there was new olive oil ready to light. So we basically center the entire holiday around oil. Everything.
Hence the frying of the food.
The fried food, exactly.
Yes.
Which is yummy. So today we're gonna make latkes. And just for, you know, expediency purposes, I kind of made the batter before, but the recipe is really simple, and I'm actually gonna start putting them in because I don't wanna have like some sort of explosion here.
That's the beauty of this delicious food, that it is simple, it's not very complicated, but it's yet so delicious.
Exactly. Yeah.
And what's in the batter?
Okay, so it's so simple. It's, well, I kind of do a really big recipe, but 5 potatoes, 5 eggs, a little bit of oil, salt, pepper, and like a sprinkle of matzo meal to hold it together. You don't need the matzo meal, so if you're gluten-free, you could just do it plain. It really holds nicely. You grate them. My children like a more smoother consistency, so I kind of run it through the food processor after I grate them, and that kind of helps it, you know, be nice and smooth and no sensory issues.
And how long do you leave it in the oil?
Oh, until it gets brown. So I'm thinking about another minute or two.
Okay, now while it's kind of cooking up, Maria said earlier when we tried them last week, we had different toppings.
Right.
We had the applesauce and the sour cream. Are those kind of the two traditional?
Those are the two traditional. I'm kind of a purist. I like them plain. but I do have some applesauce with that. And they focus a lot on dairy because part of winning the war, which was fought, was one of the heroines actually served dairy to one of the generals, one of the Greek generals, and that was a very nice story that he kind of got drunk after because he needed to drink, so he drank wine, and that kind of turned the phase of the war on, and they were able to actually win this battle. So we have our oil, our latkes, we do donuts. Some communities do donuts, they don't do latkes at all. In Hebrew they're called sufganiyot. They're fried and stuffed with jelly and powdered sugar.
I'll take both, please.
It's a very dangerous holiday.
I know, I think I need to start celebrating Hanukkah. It sounds so delicious.
Yes.
And you came on to show us how to make the perfect latke, but you also have a fun event coming up.
We do. Tomorrow night we have Cirque du Chanukah. And it's a family fun event. It's gonna be at Castlehill Country Day School, which is 3225 North Craycroft Road. And we're planning on having a really great evening. We're having the Velocity Circus. They're coming and their theme is Ignite the Night, which fits straight into Hanukkah. We're gonna ignite the light and get more light into this world with everything that isn't so nice and light. In this world, we need to bring goodness and kindness and light to this world.
So is anyone invited, whether they're
Everyone's invited. Community-wide event. Yeah. It's the Gregory School entrance, the parking lot there. So you just come in, there'll be signs, and you could buy your tickets there, or you could call us or go to our website, and there are tickets there available as well, and they'll be at will call.
And where do the proceeds go?
So to the event, to Chabad, Tucson, and to help us with what we do, which is sharing our traditions with the community.
Well, let's go ahead and take those out and look at them before the end of the segment. I want to make sure everyone sees what a beautiful job you've done.
All right.
Oh, my goodness. That looks great. And I love that the food, everything has a symbolism, has an education behind it. We were doing the dreidel during the commercial break, and you were expressing to us, you know, what happens, and, you know, that your little girls love, you know, playing and with the coins and learning at the same time.
That's right. So the dreidel has four sides, and the dreidel was actually the Greeks, the first thing that they did was they told the Jewish people that they're not allowed to learn Torah or do any of the commandments. So there was a group of Jews, they went and they kind of hid in the mountains, in the caves, and with kids. And they would, anytime someone would come, they would take out the dreidels and they would play with that and kind of fool them. So the dreidel has four letters, Nun, Gimel, He, Shin, which means in Hebrew, Nes Gadol Hayasham, a great big miracle happened there. And it's a game. Whichever letter you land on, it's different, means different things. So Nun, nothing. Sorry, skip a turn.
Right.
Gimel, you get the whole pot.
I know. and if people want to find out more, they can come to the event. And you're invited to Cirque du Chanukah on December 17th at 5:30 p.m. For more information, you can call 795-0090 or log on to ShabbatTucson.com.